No, Judy. Once she's made up her mind about something, you can't move her with a front-end loader.
There's a 5% chance that she won't survive the operation. She's not willing to take a 5% chance on leaving you alone. On the other hand, if she doesn't get something done about her condition soon, there's a 75% chance that any exertion will kill her.
If those are the odds, she'd better go in for those tests.
You're the only one that can convince her, Sharon.
Oh, my God.
What's wrong?
Over there at the bar. It's him.
Who?
Jeff Butler.
Do you want to go?
No, we can't. We've ordered.
Shall I go and ask him to leave?
No. No, please, Greg, don't annoy him.
Well, we can't let him ruin
Greg,
our dinner.
Greg, I know what I'm talking about. Perhaps it's just coincidence he's here.
I want the police. Who's there?
Police, Mrs. Fletcher.
Had a bit of trouble, ma'am. When did this happen?
About 10 minutes ago. I rang straight away.
You better take a look around outside, Frank. Ever had anything like this occur before, ma'am?
Well, only in the past couple of days. The odd telephone call, tapping at the window. I thought it was kids.
Any idea who it could be?
The only person I can think of is Jeff Butler. He's an old army mate of my husband's.
And why do you think it was him?
Well, he was up on an assault charge a few days ago. He got a good behaviour bond. My husband was the main witness against him. He threatened Jim outside the court.
I see. And where's your husband now?
Oh, he doesn't live here anymore. He lives in a hotel in Glencoe Street at the moment, but you can get him at Wentworth Detention Centre.
Wentworth?
He's a deputy governor.
Oh, fine. This, Jeff Butler, any idea where he lives?
No.
No worries, we can check it through the courts. Look, if your husband isn't living here anymore, how come this character's hassling you?
Oh, he probably blames me for getting him arrested in the first place.
Okay. Can I use your phone?
Oh, sure.
We'll put a report through to D24. Get them to send a patrol car around occasionally to keep an eye on things for you.
Thanks.
Oh, and that broken window. If you haven't got anything to board it up with, I'll draw the curtains shut and leave the lights on. Scares off burglars.
G'day, Jude.
Hi. What are you doing out of bed, client?
Oh, I'm just getting ready for work, Mrs. Jackson.
You are not going to work in your condition.
There's nothing wrong with my condition.
Of course there is. You can't mess around with a tricky ticker, you know.
There's nothing wrong with my ticker either. Look, Mrs. Jackson, I'm as strong as an ox. There's no reason I can't go back to work.
Well, that's for the doctor to decide.
What doctor? I don't want to see any doctor.
Dr. Herbert will be here later on.
Well, I'm not seeing him. It's a waste of time even dragging him in.
Oh, tell Mrs. Davidson then.
Oh, well, I'll tell her myself. Could you arrange that for me, please?
I'll see what I can do. Well, come on, Lizzie. You're going to stand there all day holding that tray while she eats?
Touchy things, hearts. You wouldn't catch me mucking around with mine.
Ah, morning, Mrs. Davidson.
Morning, Mrs. Jackson.
Judy Bryant has asked to see you. She wants to go back to work.
Oh, dear, silly woman. Why she won't take those tests is quite beyond me. I'm sure I'd be off to the hospital at the first sign of trouble.
So would I, but she's refused to see a doctor.
Well, I'd better talk to her. Bring her to my office, please.
Wendy, don't phone Dr. Herbert just yet.
Yes, officer, can I help you?
I'm looking for a Mr. Jim Fletcher.
He's not on duty yet.
I see. When's he due in?
In half an hour.
Thanks, I won't.
Is it anything urgent?
No, ma'am, just a routine matter. I just have to speak to Mr. Fletcher.
Certainly, if you'll excuse me.
Mrs. Davidson, I want to work in the garden. Now, I've got a right to work where I want to.
Prisoners' rights are always my concern. Especially the right to adequate medical attention and treatment.
Oh, we're back to that, are we?
As governor of this prison, it is my responsibility to look after your welfare.
I would have thought that my health was my own concern.
Bryant, as far as I am concerned, if you are intent on committing suicide, then you are welcome to do so. But only on the other side of the gates. I don't know what all this fuss is about. All we want you to do is to take a few simple tests. And if an operation is necessary, at least consider it.
That is out of the question.
Very well. I want you to sign this form, please.
What is it?
Just a statement confirming that you refuse recommended medical attention. Yeah. I will not have this administration blamed for the neglect of your health. And as for working, I will not be a party to the aggravation of your condition. Mrs. Jackson, Bryant is to be relieved of all duties. During work period, she is to remain in her cell.
Did you switch it off?
Of course I did, Lizzie. I'm not that dumb. Perhaps this thing's stuck. Why don't you give it a good thump?
I'd probably fall apart if I did.
Oh, I see. I get called away for 5 minutes and the whole place falls apart.
Well, it just got stuck, Bea.
Yeah, well, it's always doing that. All we've got to do is give it a good whack.
There, you see, I told you should have given it a good thump.
Oh, that will only take a minute to warm up again. We might as well have a smoker while we're waiting. Smoker, girls. Listen, how's the appeal going, Pat?
I'm not betting on it. It's 100-1 chance against me getting off.
Mm. God, I wouldn't be parting with all that dough at them odds.
Well, it's for the kids, really. I mean, if there is a chance, however small it is, I've got to take it for their sake.
Yeah, we do some silly things for our kids sometimes. Listen, how are you going to manage what with your mother having sold the house and everything?
Oh, we'll get by. We'll all be together, that's the main thing.
Hey, Lizzie, let's put your hand under that for me.
Oh, it's hot!
Guess it must be hot enough to start work, then.
Come on, Anderson. You've been weeding that same patch for the last 10 minutes.
Oh, sorry, Miss Phillip.
I'm looking for a Mr. Fletcher.
Yeah, that's me.
Where were you around about 10 o'clock last night?
Well, I was with a friend. Why?
Your wife had a visitor. Unfortunately, he left a brick instead of a calling card right through the window.
Are they all right?
Your wife's a bit upset, but that's understandable.
Thank God.
Do you know anything about it?
Well, surely you don't think I had anything to do with it.
It has been known to happen, sir. Married couples separate. A bit of ill feeling.
Yeah, well, that's not my style.
Mrs. Fletcher thought it could have been a Jeff Butler.
Yes, that's possible.
She said he threatened you.
Well, it wasn't a threat exactly, more heat-of-the-moment stuff, you know.
Do you know where he is now?
Well, last I heard, he was somewhere in Coburg.
No, he isn't there. We've checked. He hasn't been there since the trial.
Well, then I'm afraid I can't help you. We didn't part the best of friends, exactly.
Well, look, if you see him, you'll let me know. Right?
Yes, of course.
Good.
Never let you forget a parking ticket, did I? Morning.
Oh. The police were here earlier asking for you.
Yes, I know. I saw them outside.
Well, nothing serious, I hope.
No. No, at least I hope not. Somebody threw a brick through our window last night.
Oh, my God.
Mm. Leela thinks Jeff Butler might have done it. What I can't understand is why he'd go to so much trouble to play such a childish trick. Why doesn't he wait for me on some dark corner and then knock my block off?
Perhaps he knows he wouldn't beat you. When did you say this was?
Last night.
Yes, but what time?
Oh, about 10 o'clock, the police thing.
Well, it couldn't have been Jeff Butler. I mean, Greg Miller and I were having dinner at a restaurant last night and he was sitting at the bar. I mean, he couldn't have left before 11:30.
It's a bit strange, isn't it?
It's hardly the word I'd use for it. That man terrifies me.
Good morning, Mr. Reed, Mr. Pierce. Please sit down.
Mrs. Davidson, Paul has told me your views on the drama group. I must say I'm very pleased.
I hope he also told you my views on staging a free-for-all in the recreation room.
I'm sorry, that was my fault. I should have realized things were getting out of hand.
Well, you weren't entirely to blame. There were certain personality clashes which triggered it off.
Well, I've been inside long enough to recognize the symptoms, but I'm afraid I didn't. It won't happen again.
I hope not, because just for once, I would like a recreational project to succeed.
I'm sure it will, once we have their interest.
Oh, I've used some of the money from the radio project to buy them some books.
Shakespeare?
Yes, I thought we'd start off with a play reading.
Well, really, I don't think you're likely to get much enthusiasm with Shakespeare.
Oh, I don't know. There's nothing like jumping in at the deep end. You see, the main trouble with his writing is that the style is too old-fashioned for people to understand. Explain it to them in modern terms and they come to appreciate it.
And Ken has had some success in other jails.
Well, the best of luck, Mr. Pierce, and plenty of it.
All right, you lot, stop work. Pay attention.
Well, no doubt B. Smith has already told you that the governor wants us to go ahead with this drama project. So Ken Pierce will be visiting us on a regular basis to supervise. Ken, would you like to...
I'd like to go on to a play reading to get some idea of what you can all do. Paul's got hold of this play for us, and I'd like you to each choose a character, and then we can give it a burl.
A Midsummer Night's Dream? You have got to be joking.
I did this when I was a nipper at school, I think.
Oh, get off it, Lizzie. You never went to school. They weren't invented in your day.
Of course I did. I went to school in the country. Just one room and all the kids in together. Every year we used to do a play for the grown-ups. Oh, it used to be easy. Except for one year and we got this Drongo of a teacher who wanted us to get cultured. And he made us do Shakespeare and I got lumbered with Oberon. I learned it all off like a parrot and
whoever it is can wait.
It's Leela.
Oh, look, take Ken and Paul back with you, will you? And make sure they don't interrupt work for too long.
B, could you get the women to read through the play and then write down anything they don't understand?
Oh, yeah. I can do that for you.
Good.
What do you want? You know I don't like you coming here.
Well, I'm sorry, but I rang your hotel last night and there was no answer. I don't know how to get in touch with you when you're off duty.
Look, we can't talk here. Come inside.
Have the police been to see you?
Yes, they wanted to know where I was last night.
Well, surely I don't think it was you.
Well, obviously not. And it can't have been Jeff either. Meg saw him at a restaurant last night.
Is she certain?
Well, she's hardly likely to make a mistake like that, is she?
Well, if it wasn't him... What about your girlfriend's husband?
No, it was probably a prowler or some kids skylarking.
Oh, rubbish. Wonderful, isn't it? You go out and play around and I'm the one who has to sit at home and suffer for it.
Oh, come off it, Leela.
Goodbye, Jim.
I reckon Shakespeare's a bit heavy to start off with.
Yeah, I must say I was rather looking forward to something just a bit spicier.
What have you got?
It's our play for the drama group. Here's your copy, kid. Start reading.
Oh, thanks. Gee, there's a lot of words.
Here's a line about Vera. No, no, for I'm as ugly as a bear and beasts that see me run away for fear.
Oh, here's your sexy bit, Bea.
Where?
One turf shall serve as pillow for us both. One heart, one bed, two bosoms, and one troth.
Sounds a bit deformed to me.
What's a troth?
Use your imagination.
All right, what's all this noise about?
We're just looking at the books Mr. Reed gave us, Mr. Fletcher.
Well, you can do that in the recreation room. You're supposed to be in the dining room now.
Oh, God. Yeah, someone should give him the Iron Cross.
Yeah, well, don't worry, Bede. The cops are closing in on him anyway.
What was that, Anderson?
Oh, nothing, Mr. Fletcher.
You made a comment. What was it?
She said it was nothing.
Shut up, Smith.
Well?
I didn't mean anything.
I'm not interested in what you meant. I'm getting sick and tired of you lot and your smart comments. Report to me after lunch, Anderson. You're going up to see the governor.
Now, fair go.
One word out of you, Smith, and you'll join her.
Oh, come on, Bea.
And then I asked her to repeat the remark, and she refused.
I see. Well, Doreen, what do you have to say?
Well, crikey, Mrs. Davidson, it was only a bit of a joke.
I'm afraid I can't share your sense of humour when it involves insolence to an officer.
I wasn't. All I said was that the cops were closing in on
him. And what is that supposed to mean?
Like I said, it was only a joke.
There seems to be a growing tendency for the women to counter an officer's order with a wisecrack. I will not tolerate it. You will go without buyer privileges for a week.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson.
That is all, Doreen. You may go. I'd like a word with you, Mr. Fletcher, about the rosters. You may go back to the garden, Doreen. Was that really necessary?
What?
Bringing Doreen in on such a trivial matter.
Well, I don't consider insubordination trivial.
Neither do I. However, I do feel you overreacted. Look, I know you're having a few personal problems, but so are the women. It's not like you to let your personal life impair your judgment at work.
I don't.
Nevertheless, I have just had to penalize Doreen to show support of you. I do not like doing so because of such a harmless remark.
Hello, Leela. Did you get in touch with Jim?
Yes, for all the good it did me. How are the boys?
Good as gold. Didn't even notice them. They're watching TV now.
I'll go and get them.
No, leave them. I'll send them home when the program's finished.
Oh, thanks, Julie. I could really do with a nice quiet cup of tea.
Heard anything from the police?
No. But it couldn't have been the man I thought it was. He was seen in a restaurant all last night.
God help us if there's a prowler loose in the neighbourhood.
Amen to that.
See you.
Thanks for looking after the boys.
Okay.
Not say so, Lysander, say not so. What though he love your Hermia? Lord, what though? Yet Hermia still loves you. Then be content.
Lysander?
Lizzie, that's you.
Ah. Content with the Hermia, I do repent. What's wrong?
It's Hermia, not hernia.
Well, that's what I said, only it came out the wrong way.
It's trouble with hernias.
All right, Smith, it's not a comedy.
Well, that's funny. It says it is in the front of the book.
For, as a serviette... Oh, surfeit of the sweetest things... The deepest loathing to the stomach brings.
Sounds like prison food.
Hey, wait a minute. You jumped a whole page, Lizzie.
Oh, I'm sick of this stuff. I'm going to bed. I'm not going to stay here and be laughed at.
You silly old coot.
Phyllis, you read her part, will you? Go on, Pat.
Oh. Wherefore was I to this keen mockery born? When at your hands did I deserve this scorn?
Get off my back, will you, Sharon?
Heaven's sake, Jude, it's only a few tests. Why are you so touchy about it?
Well, I've done all right so far, haven't I?
You're not getting any younger, you know.
Oh, thanks a lot.
I didn't mean it that way, love.
It's just that when you're young, you don't have to look after yourself quite so much. And I don't want anything to happen to you, Jude.
Well, nothing is going to happen to me because I'm not going to let some doctor practice on me.
You don't even know if you need an operation.
Well, I'll never find out, will I? Because I'm not going to have the test.
At least have the tests done.
No! Listen, that's what happened to my mother, remember? First it was just a few tests. Then it was just a simple little operation. Been done 1,000 times before.
It was years ago. They can do marvels now, Jude.
You have any idea how many people go into that operating theater and never come out?
Oh, some, maybe, yeah. But not many. Won't you please take those tests? For me, Jude.
Will you get off my back, Sharon?
Jude!
I'm going to the rec room. I don't have to listen to this shit anymore.
Bit of a worry, isn't it? Frightening thing, a heart attack. Makes you wake up to yourself. If Jude knew how bad it could be, she'd go and have those tests.
She lets it go that far, Lizzie. It'll probably be too late.
Yeah. Listen. What do you reckon about this for an idea?
What are you doing here?
Reading a book at the minute.
I'm not paying you good money to laze around.
Nobody works a 24-hour day.
Look, I don't care how long you work, as long as the job gets done.
It'll get done.
When?
Everything's going according to plan.
Look, I expect results and I don't expect to do the work myself.
What?
I'm paying the money. You're supposed to be taking the risks. Don't see why I should have to creep around in the middle of the night throwing bricks through windows.
Look, I told you after that little talk I had with Fletcher, I'll be the number one suspect. I had to make myself an alibi.
Well, I hope you made it a good one.
I sure did. There's no way in the world Meg Jackson would ever lie for me. And if they don't believe her, they won't believe anyone.
Look, how long do you think it's going to take to get this bastard away from Caroline?
I don't know. But don't fret about it. When I'm finished with him, he'll never see your wife again.
Good. Just as long as no one gets hurt.
Oh, no one's going to get hurt.
Say, gentle Helena, hear my excuse, my love. My life, my soul, fair Helena.
Oh, excellent. Sweet, do not scorn her so.
If she cannot entreat, I can compel.
Thou canst compel no more than she entreat.
Hey, that's my line. I'm Lysander.
Yeah, well, I thought you'd buzzed off, so Phyllis has been reading it.
Oh, God, hadn't gotten any idea. I've done this before, you know. I was Oberon.
Yeah, we know, we know.
Thou canst not compel no more than she entreat my
How's
threats
it going?
Have no
It'd be
more
hilarious
strength.
If it wasn't so pathetic.
Mm. Then
fancy trying to get these women to read Shakespeare.
Yeah, well, Lisa keeps them out of trouble.
I mean, until they figure a way of using it to
I
their
advantage.
I
swear by that which I will lose for thee to prove him false that say I love him not.
I say I love thee more than he can do.
If you say so, withdraw and prove it too.
Quick, come.
Doreen, that's you.
Oh, Lysander, where to tends all this?
Away, the E.T.R. Oh, oh, oh.
Lizzie, you
it's
all
a
right?
Hey, step back, give her air.
Get her pockets, her pills should be there. Quickly, get us some water.
Stand
get
back,
her pills.
Stand back. Let's have a look. Come on, Smith, help me get me to hospital. Come on, quick.
Here, give us a pill. You got them?
Yes, come on.
Give us a hand, Smith.
Jim, is that you?
Michael, is it you?
Ugh, typical. Hiding behind bushes, too scared to show your face. For God's sake, grow up. Michael?
Bastard, you can crawl back home now. You've had your kicks for tonight. Slammed behind me. Must have been the wind.
Hi, Greg.
G'day, Jim. You on your way home?
Yeah, yeah.
Just called by to see Pat O'Connell about her appeal.
Ah. Look, you used to be quite friendly with Lizzie Birdsworth, didn't you?
Yes, I suppose so. She used to drive me crazy with her visits, fossicking around, trying to find things to pinch.
Yeah, well, look, she had one of her attacks yesterday, we think.
Oh, yes. Well, what did Dr. Herbert say?
Well, by the time he got there, she'd already taken one of her pills, so she seemed all right.
Well, I think I'd better take a look at her anyway.
Thanks.
Okay, see you
later.
Hello, Lizzie. How are you?
Oh, good day, Doctor. It's good to see you.
Lizzie, have you been up to your tricks again?
Me? No. I was just doing a bit of acting. You know, I was playing Lysander in A Midsummer Night's Dream. I played Oberon once, years ago when I was a nipper. Anyway, all of a sudden, B and Mr. Fletcher grabbed me and marched me in here.
For no reason at all?
No. They must have been overwhelmed by me acting.
Yes, I can guess what sort of acting you were doing. Lizzie, you've got to stop crying wolf with that heart of yours. One of these days you're going to have a really severe attack and everyone's just going to sit round and watch.
I suppose you're right.
What's Mrs. Davidson going to say when she finds this is just another of your little games?
Oh, you're not going to tell her, are you? I mean, you don't even work here anymore. Anyway, I did it for a good reason.
Yeah? What was that?
You know Jude Bryant?
Yes.
Well, I wanted to show her what a real heart attack is like. I wanted to make her take notice and take some of them tests.
Really?
Doc.
Yes, well, she's being rather silly about it all.
Can't you spread it around that I'm on my last legs? That'd really shake her up a bit, I know.
You're not dragging me into your scheme.
Well, you're not going to tell the governor, are you?
Yes, I am. You're perfectly well, and it's unfair to let people go worrying about you unnecessarily.
All right.
Look, I've got to go and talk to Pat. I won't be leaving the prison and seeing Mrs. Davidson for a while yet, so you've got 1 hour for your scheme to work.
Oh, Doc, your blood's worth bottling.
But if anyone asks me, I'm not going to lie.
Fair enough.
Oh, hi. Come in, come in. Would you like a drink?
I'd love one.
All right. How things been?
I had a visitor last night.
Oh, yeah? Who?
Didn't say. Whoever it was just sneaked around the house shaking bushes. Scared the life out of me. I think it was Michael. At least I hope it was.
Yeah, that figures. He hasn't the guts to face me himself, so he takes it out on you and Leela. Well, he's not going to get away with it this time.
Well, I can't be sure it was him.
Oh, it's him, all right. Well, that's it.
But, Jim, you're playing right into his hands.
What do you mean?
Well, that's exactly how he wants you to react. If you go around there and punch him in the nose, he's going to lay an assault charge on you and have proof about us.
Yeah, I suppose you're right. I'd better tell the police. They're trying to find Jeff Butler. It can't be him. I wish it were. Then I'd know how to handle it.
Look, don't tell the police. I mean, I really couldn't stand to have them all over the place.
That slimy little snake isn't going to get away with this.
He hasn't got the guts to be anything but a nuisance. If we ignore him, he'll go away.
Are you sure?
Yes, I am.
Doctor.
Oh, hello, Judy.
Have you come to see Lizzie?
Well, not specifically, but I did see her.
Is she all right?
Well, at Lizzie's age, heart trouble can be very dangerous. She's had several bad attacks, each one leaving her weaker.
Is she going to be all right?
Lizzie can't be cured by surgery, and even if she could, her age would make it difficult. She's not young and strong anymore.
Is she going to die?
Well, she takes it easy. She'll be around for a while yet.
You know, it was sudden. I mean, one minute she was standing there sprouting Shakespeare, the next...
Yes, I know. I must admit I feel helpless at times like that. Especially when something could have been done about it and wasn't.
I'm going to end up like her, aren't I, Doctor?
I've no idea. I really don't know what's wrong with you. But if what I suspect is true, then there's no reason why you should, when a simple operation could give you a perfectly normal life. I must be going.
Doctor.
Yes, Judy?
I will have the tests.
Fine. I'll speak to Mrs. Davidson and arrange for you to visit hospital.
Why should I?
The drama group. Your man will be coming in.
Yeah. Is it a bird? Is it a plane?
It's Super King.
Now, don't talk crap.
We didn't mean anything.
It's only a joke. Well, I'm not in the mood for jokes. With poor Lizzie at the hospital, and nobody telling us how she is. What's so bloody funny?
Nothing.
Then wipe that smile off your face before I do it for you with my fist. Lizzie could be dead for all we know.
Who's dead?
What are you doing in here? You're supposed to be resting.
Nothing wrong with me. It worked, love. I just saw the doc and she says she'll take the test.
Oh, thanks, Lizzie. You're
now,
a marvel.
Just hang on a minute. You mean you put all that on?
Yeah. I had to show Jude that you have to take a weak heart seriously.
Well, who cares about that fat cow? Bloody hell, Lizzie, you scared us.
Oh, come on, Bee. Lizzie's all right and she did it for a good reason.
Yeah. Judy Bryant, what did she ever do for anybody? No skin off your nose if she's too stupid to get herself fixed up.
She had to see it was for her own good. Besides, we cardiac cases have to stick together.
Stopped work again. Oh, no, don't tell me. You were just discussing the finer points of Shakespeare. O'Connell, you're wanted in the governor's office.
What for, Miss Bennett?
I don't know. Just get moving.
Oh.
Hello, Pat. How are you?
I thought Mrs. Davidson wanted to see me.
Thank you, Vera.
I'll be outside if you need me.
Both the interview rooms were occupied, so Mrs. Davidson said I could use her office. Sit down. How do you feel about the appeal? Carmel asked me if I'd speak for you.
Yes, she told me. Please don't feel you have to.
I would have wanted to, even if she hadn't asked.
That's very kind of you.
No, it's not. It's selfish. I still feel responsible for your being here. Look, Pat, what happened is history. You've got two little kids who are just living for the day when they can be back with their mother. Now, you think about that, eh?
That's all I am thinking about. It doesn't change the facts.
I was guilty. They won't let me off.
Hey, Lizzie, there's a place here for you. Mouse, you can sit there.
Has everyone got their books?
Mm. Oh, somebody spilled coffee all over mine.
Good day, Miss Bennett. Have you come in to join us?
Here, you can read my part if you like. Vinegar Titania.
Well, are we all set to go?
Yeah, of course. G'day, Ken.
G'day. Well, it's good to see everyone so keen. Okay, let's get straight into it, shall we? Did everyone get a part to read?
Oh, yeah, we had to double up on a few of them, though.
No worries. Okay. A Midsummer Night's Dream. Now, this is known as a Shakespearean comedy.
Yeah, well, I don't think it's that funny. I think it's stupid.
Well, let's just take a look at it as we go through it, eh? Don't forget, this was written 400 years ago. People laughed at different things in those days.
Yeah, ask Lizzie. She'd remember.
Now, the characters
well, it seems to be going quite well, doesn't it?
Give it time. There's nothing They'll mess deep it up or as soon as they get bored.
Did you manage to read it all?
You really love success, yeah, don't you, Miss Bennett?
Great. Okay, any questions before we start?
Oh, yeah. I got one. How come some of it's in poetry and some of it isn't?
The bits about the workmen are in prose. Mm. Do you know what prose is?
You've got quite a few of them in here.
It's just to show that the workmen were lower class. In those days, all the silver tails must have talked in verse. Oh. Any other questions? Lizzie?
Me? Oh, no, I've done it before, you know. I was Oberon.
Oh. You met by moonlight, proud Titania.
Yeah, that's right.
Hello?
This is Jim Fletcher.
Yes?
I think we've had enough of your party tricks, don't you?
What are you talking about?
Your silly games. It's just your style, isn't it? Frightening innocent women and children. Well, I'm onto you, son, so just back off.
Look, I don't know what you're accusing me of, but...
Oh, public nuisance, willful damage to property, breaking an entry. The police could use that for a start.
You can't prove a thing.
Oh, of course not. Yes, you'd have a cast-iron alibi, wouldn't you? Well, I just might take a leaf out of your book, Mr. Simpson. I'll organize 12 people to swear that I was with them, then come around and give you a lesson in unarmed combat.
Are you threatening me?
Hey, 10 out of 10 for intelligence. Now lay off.
That was Fletcher, threatening to put me in hospital.
Good.
What?
Well, it shows we're getting to him. And that he's worried about Leela.
But how long is this going to go on for? Till he creeps up behind me one dark night?
Why not? Then you seal the cops onto the bastard for assault. That's what he did to me.
I've got more concern for my health. There's got to be a quicker way.
There is. We plant some dope on him and give the cops a call.
Where will we get the dope?
Leave that to me. I've got contacts for all sorts of things.
He'd lose his job.
Yeah. Shame, isn't it? And he'd get 5 years.
As much as that?
Reckon.
Caroline wouldn't wait that long for him.
Alack, where are you? Speak, and if you hear, speak of all loves. I swoon almost with fear. No? Then I well perceive you are not nigh. Either death or you, I'll find immediately, I.
Exit and end of Act Two. Okay, ladies, that's as far as we'll go today. What do you think of Shakespeare now? Still a lot of old rubbish?
Oh, no, I suppose I understand a bit better now.
Yeah, me too, I suppose.
Good, good. Well, I'll tell you what, we'll carry on at the next meeting, and if you have any questions, please write them down, eh? Yeah. And ladies, thanks for the good work. It won't be long before you're putting on your own play if you keep this up.
Girls, I reckon we could show Ken our appreciation.
All right, the fun's over. Get these chairs back where they came from. And move yourselves. You've got an exercise period in 2 minutes. Come on.
Congratulations. You did a good job there.
Oh, what did I do?
Well, I just had the feeling that there wouldn't have been much interest if it wasn't for you showing them away.
Oh, no, they enjoy it, but they just need someone to encourage them, that's all.
And what about you?
Relieves the boredom.
It can get you down, can't it?
You manage to beat it.
Sure, sure. But there's others who can. And there's others who can. Provided they got someone to show them the way.
You going to show me the way?
If you like.
Well, if you're ready, I'll take you down to reception and you can sign out.
Fine, thanks, Paul. I'll see you next time, B.
Yeah, see you.
Bye, ladies. And thanks for the good work.
Bye.
Well, come on, you lot. You've got 10 minutes in the garden before dinner. Now move.
I really enjoyed that. Didn't you, Doreen?
Oh, yeah, I thought it was good. Still reckon that Shakespeare bloke could have written proper English. All them highfalutin words and everything back to front. You could read it over 10 times and you still wouldn't understand a word of it.
Yeah, well, I reckon we should have got Ken to take a part. Because when he read some of them bits out, I could really understand it. Yeah, he could have done Oberon, the Fairy King and Queen Bee. How do you reckon he'd be as the Fairy King, Bee?
I don't reckon he's a fairy at all.
It'd be just your luck if he was.
I wouldn't care either way. Oh, go on. I bet you'd like to get him in the storeroom for 10 minutes.
Yeah, and I'll bet if he forced himself on you, you wouldn't even scream.
Not until afterwards, isn't he?
This is supposed to be an exercise period. That doesn't mean exercising your mouths.
Bitch.
If her ears were any bigger, I reckon she'd take off in a head, wouldn't she?
Mm.
Hey, Bay, here he comes.
Well, that seemed to go okay.
Yes, let's hope it keeps up that way. Although I did detect a certain amount of flagging among the women partway through that.
Oh, that's usual. Next time it'll probably be worse. And before you know it, they'll start reading things into it and be clamoring to do Macbeth.
You make it sound like a mathematical formula.
Oh, no, Paul, no, no. It's never as impersonal as that. The crims are people, usually with less education than others. Shakespeare to them comes under the heading culture, something to avoid as being too difficult to understand. You know, if you spend all your life being called a dumb, stupid, no-hoper, you get to be that way after a time. Then someone gives you a push to make you try harder. Before you know it, a glimmer of understanding shines through. Now, that glimmer, that feeling that you can work out something difficult all by yourself, that's enough to keep you pushing on.
Mm. That's quite a speech.
Nothing worse than a convert, is there?
Yeah, I'll catch up with you later.
Okay, Paul, see you. Hi, Annie. What have you been up to, eh?
I wonder why older men always go after younger women.
Oh, you're back then.
Just passing through. I have to meet a client an hour. He left his marketing report behind. Did you get the stuff?
Not yet.
Are you sure you'll be able to get it?
Look, I've told you I've got good contacts. Don't panic.
I just want this whole business over with.
The parcel will be ready tomorrow afternoon. You can deliver it then.
Well, why do I have to get involved? Can't you deliver it?
Look, if you arrive at the hotel, Fletcher will take one look inside the package and it's game, set and match for you. I've got to make sure he's not there.
How?
That's my problem. Yours is to deliver the parcel.
Okay. I'll see you later.